Hi, welcome to in 5 minutes. Next is again the MOSFET design. What you can see, it is again N MOSFET. Instead of the resistance, they have given you the constant current source, that is IQ is given instead of the resistance. So this type is another what you can get in your paper. So in this case, we need to first check whether the transistor is in saturation. So going over with our usual steps, what are your usual steps? That is assuming the transistor in the saturation region. So what you can say, if the transistor is in saturation region, ID is KN dash upon 2 into W by L into VGS minus VTN the whole square. So when you substitute the values, ID is given 250 microamperes, KN dash is given, W by L is given, then you can find VGS, VTN is given as 0.8. So from this you can find VGS as 2.24 volts. Now from the diagram you can say this is AC source, which we are not considering in the DC analysis. So it has been open circuited, and since the current flowing through RG is zero, we are not considering these two over here. So it is grounded. So what you can say, VGS is VG minus VS. Since VG is 0, from the diagram you can say gate is grounded, you can say VGS is minus VS, or VS is minus VGS. So we can get VS as minus 2.24 volts, right? Now when you apply KVL in this loop, what will be the equation for KVL? It will be 5 minus ID into RD minus VD equals to 0, or you can say ID will be 5 minus VD upon, or you can say we need to find the value of the resistance RD. We can say RD is nothing but 5 minus VD upon IDQ. So VD is given as 2.5 volts in the question. Substituting, you will get it as 10 kilo ohms. So this completes the design, but we need to check whether the transistor is in saturation. So for that, we know VDS is VD minus VS. VD is 2.5, VDS is minus 2.24. This will give you 4.74 volts. Now we can find VDS sat. VDS sat is VGS minus VTN. VGS is 2.24 and VTN is 0.8, that is 1.44 volts. What we can say from this two equation, your VDS is greater than VDS sat, that means the transistor which we have assumed in the saturation region is right, and whatever value of RD we have got is right. Why we are doing this? If the transistor is not in saturation, then the equation for the current will change and the value of IDQ would be changed and the value of RD would have changed, right? So for this we need to check whether the transistor is operating in the saturation region. Thank you for watching in 5 minutes.